I'm Jason Edwards. This is LNC News, and we're out at the 91st annual NAACP event here at the Marriott. And ma'am, I'm sorry, your name?
My name is June Fawcett Hub.
Hey, June, and how are you enjoying your evening?
I'm enjoying it very much.
How are you enjoying the setup of the whole, everything that they put together?
Oh, I love it. It's just great. It's always really nice here, always. I've played here for each one of these banquets almost every year, and it's always been wonderful.
You know, Senator Godot, I've just been overwhelmed about this whole evening. How have you been feeling about this whole evening?
Oh, I feel just fabulous. Just at the end when they gave the closing prayer and I held hands with some white firemen, and afterwards he gave me the biggest hug ever, and I could just feel the love in the room. It feels like all the black people, white people, and brown people here tonight, we just became one tonight. And I'm just looking for bigger and brighter things for all of us in this community of the city of Wichita and Sedgwick. Because tonight was about freedom and social justice, but the only way we can come up from that is to get economic justice. We've got to get some money to be able to provide for our families, and then all of us can then have a piece of that American apple pie and live the American dream. And that's what I'm looking. This night was about people, not black people, but all people. And we're in this together, and I'm fighting for us. But as the speaker said tonight, we've come a long way, but we still have a long way to go.
And I'm speaking with
Dolores Cox.
Dolores Cox, are you related to Kenya Cox?
Yes, I am.
All right. And how are you enjoying this event this evening?
It's a special occasion as usual. I always enjoy the banquets.
And you guys looking forward to the food?
It gets better.
Each one gets better? All right. Is the food going to get better this year?
I hope so.
All right. The Marriott covering the 91st anniversary of the Legacy Awards banquet. And to my left, I am interviewing
Daryl Pope.
And Daryl, I know something about you. You're with the NAACP. Can you just give a little bit of your resume?
Yes, I'm the president of the Hutchinson branch of the NAACP and have been for 41 years, and it's a pleasure to be here this evening.
All right. And to my right, I'm sorry, ma'am, your name is?
My name is Tawanda Hamilton of Tangles Unlimited here in City, Wichita.
And Ms. Tawanda, we know about your hairstyles up at Tangles Unlimited. Do you think the food is going to be as good tonight as your hairstyles are as Tangled Unlimited?
Well, so far they get an A. I've been nibbling on my dessert before food, so yes, I'm hoping that it's going to be delicious.
And do you guys see any uplifting as far as in the black community, not only in Wichita, but in Kansas? I believe that the NAACP has been a lot stronger, and especially with the NAACP National Doral Chairman coming down. How do you feel about that, being working in Kansas for so long?
I think that it's excellent. I think that it's really a compliment to Kansas to have the chairman come down here when it's the first. And I think that the work of the NAACP in blazing the trail and more or less the frontier for civil rights is starting to manifest itself in some of the things we're seeing.
Well, I'm guilty because I'm not a member of the NAACP, but I do want to get involved because I do give back a lot to the community. But I'm glad that they do have sponsorships and they have businesses that come out and support. I'm here also in support of Ms. Mamie Lewis. She's been a definitely an inspiration in our community for over the last 35 years. So I'm just happy and delighted that we could come together as one and unite and hopefully keep it going strong.
My name is Carl Kirkendall.
And Carl, we out here at the 91st banquet for the NAACP. And how are you feeling about this event this evening so far?
I like it. A little nervous, but I like it.
And we have the national chairman of the NAACP in the house coming out to Wichita. How do you feel about that?
Excited. You know, more people coming here. We're getting known, I guess.
Out here with two young gentlemen. First of all, to my left, I got
Roderick Ferguson.
And to my right, I got
Lyndon Breckenridge.
And it's Washington. I'm sorry, your name one more time for
Roderick.
Me. Roderick, how are you feeling about this evening?
This is a good event for people to come out here and learn what the NAACP is and how it's been going on for so many years.
And I'm sorry, your name one more time for me?
It's Lyndon Breckenridge.
And how are you feeling about this evening?
I'm feeling pretty good. I know my grandpa, he's getting an award for this, and I think it's good to see that everyone here is going to get to see who's getting an award, and even some people are going to get awards themselves, so, you know, it's going to be pretty good.
You look like you guys are young, aspiring black men, and you guys trying to follow the pattern of Barack Obama or anybody as far as doing politics or any of that aspect, or business owners like Mike Pompeo or something to that effect? Just kind of hanging out right now, I understand. That's what's good, that's what's good. All right, you guys enjoy your dinner, all right? All right.
My name is Annie, W-O-R-K, no S.
I'm doing Annie Work. I apologize, Ms. Work.
Okay.
And how are you feeling about the NAACP event tonight?
I think it's very nice. Really, can I say a little cutie thing? I think I should have been awarded something too, but I'm just teasing. This is a tease.
And you've been in broadcast for a while, journalism.
12 years.
For 12 years?
Uh-huh, and I worked for KWCH-TV, and I was a reporter and there too, because I helped, might not see me on air all the time, but I did help with stories and things.
And how do you feel about the National Board of Directors Chairman coming down to Wichita?
Well, I just think the board came down and she needs to get us straightened, the president straightened a little bit and some of the things that we need to know, because I really think the Intrust Bank is one of the things I would like to talk about, that we should have some more African American or some groups there. And that's kind of what I'd like, because all the entertainment is not any African American, but you know, that's part of life. You know, okay.
Ms. Work, we thank you for everything that you've done for this community, and on behalf of the community, we really appreciate you. I'm with the mayor, Carr Brewer. Carr, how are you feeling?
Oh, very excited, very energized. They had a wonderful speaker. I mean, she hit the nail right on the head, and everything that this community is needing and everything they've done, I mean, you couldn't ask for anything more.
Now, Mr. Mayor, I tell you, I'm originally from St. Louis, but I went to Wichita State, and I can honestly say that I'm honored and privileged to be part of this, because even being from a community of St. Louis, I really haven't seen this much culture brought to, you know, not only my own hometown, but especially Wichita.
Uh-huh.
How do you feel, and how do you think that's going to change as far as with not only our young youth, but the black people in general, and people in general in our culture and city?
Well, I think it's going to have a huge impact. I mean, I think you can see that by the reaction of the people that were here tonight. And we had a very, very diverse crowd. But it also was a strong message that was sent to our children that, yes, we've come a long way, and there are a lot of people that were recognized tonight that made those sacrifices and made it where we could do what we're doing tonight. It hasn't been that long ago. So when we start looking at those types of things, our children are seeing these and saying, okay, we just got a history lesson in just a few hours that you probably would have taken 2 or 3 years to get. And, oh, by the way, there's more to be done. So they know that tonight is the night that they captured all that. In fact, I just had a young man that's standing over there that walked up to me. And as I was coming out the dais, and he said, Mayor, can I talk with you? He says, you spoke to my group 2 years ago. He said, you said one of us in this room will be the next mayor. We will be the next African-American mayor. And he's in his second year of college, and he says, I want to be that next guy. Can you help me? Now that is the portion that's sent in the seed, that's sent in the message that change is among us. There's opportunities here for us. And he's identifying, laying the path, and saying, I want to be that person. So what more can you ask for? The young people have already figured out that there's opportunities for them. And there's still work that we have to do, and they're willing, you know, you just hand them the baton and let them take the rest of the way.
Well, Mr. Mayor, on behalf of LNC News and the rest of the Wichita community, we'd like to thank you, and we appreciate you for the job that you've done, for helping putting these events together, and we hope that God bless you throughout your tenure and everything that you do.
Well, thank you. We've got a wonderful